Kennedy Center Honors, honoring Andrew Lloyd Webber, Zubin Mehta, Dolly Parton, Smokey Robinson, Steven Spielberg, Sarah Brightman.
I have been privileged to know Andrew now for 26 years and have seen many sides to this complex and unique man. I have seen the searching and brilliant mind that has found hit shows in the pages of the Old Testament or the poems of T.S. Eliot. He is by turns, and Andrew, don't kill me for saying this, funny, boyish, self-effacing, adorable, complicated, passionate, exasperating, lovable, explosive, demanding, innovative, and often extremely outrageous. When he is composing, it only looks as if he is in the room with you. In reality, he is far, far away in some exalted place where there is only him and the notes. But when he comes back, he brings with him music that is exciting, moving, and beautiful. That is why tonight and every night, people around the world are going to see Andrew Lloyd Webber shows and will continue to do so long after this curtain has come down, long after all of us here have made our final curtain calls. Because his music of the night is music for all time. He grew up in a house of symphonies, sonatas, and music lessons. His father was director of the London College of Music. At school, they taught him Mozart and Bach, but he wanted to write another kind of music, like Rodgers and Hammerstein and Elvis. Maybe he could combine them. He teamed up with songwriter Tim Rice. When a boys' school asked them to write a cantata, they chose a Bible story. It grew from a school concert to a full-blown musical, Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. We were out to shake up the musical, he said. The next idea was so outrageous. No producer would touch it. They made a record instead. Kids couldn't buy it fast enough. When it finally hit the stage, it rocked the house. For Andrew, it always begins with music and the search for the melody that lifts the story onto the stage and into history. Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is I never left you. All through my wild days. A hit in London, the show charged into New York, rest of America. Don't your disdain. Next, the poems of T.S. Eliot. Cats became the longest running show in Broadway history. I love theatre, he said, when it totally envelops you. He had raised Broadway entertainment to operatic heights. He dreamed of writing like his heroes, Now it's his music that belongs to the world.
Help me make the music of the night.
Kennedy Center Honors will return with Josh Groban, Betty Buckley, and Reba McEntire. Ladies and gentlemen, in tribute to Andrew Lloyd Webber, Corey Glover. Ladies and gentlemen, the star of Grey Gardens, Christine Ebersole.
I don't know why I'm frightened. I know my way around here. The cargo trees, the painted seas, the sound here. I don't want to be alone.
Ladies and gentlemen, from London, the star of Evita, Elena Roger.
What's new? Buenos Aires! I knew I wanna see him just a little stuff on you. You'll be on me too. I get out here, Buenos Aires. Stand back, you wanna know what you're gonna get in me. Just a little touch of stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, Josh Groban. From the original Broadway production of Cats, Betty Buckley.
Smiling alone.
again.
Daylight, I must wait for the sunrise. I must think of a new life, and I mustn't give in. When the dawn comes, tonight will be a memory too, and a new day will begin.
The original London production of Cats, Sarah Brightman.
Sunlight through the trees in summer, and the stars parading
like a flower as the dawn is breaking.
The man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the star of Grey Gardens, Christine Ebersole.
I don't know why I'm frightened. I know my way around here. The cardboard trees, the painted seas, the sound here. In this ever-spinning
as if we never...
Josh Groban. From the original Broadway production of Cats, Betty Buckley.
Midnight, not a sound from the pavement, as the moon lost her memory, she is smiling alone. I remember a time I knew what happiness was. The memory live again. Daylight, I must wait for the sunrise.
The Kennedy Center Honors, honoring Andrew Lloyd Webber, Zubin Mehta, Dolly Parton, Smokey Robinson, Steven Spielberg, Sarah Brightman.
I have been privileged to know Andrew now for 26 years and have seen many sides to this complex and unique man. I have seen the searching and brilliant mind that has found hit shows in the pages of the Old Testament or the poems of T.S. Eliot. He is by turns, and Andrew, don't kill me for saying this, funny, boyish, self-effacing, adorable, complicated, passionate, exasperating, lovable, explosive, demanding, innovative, and often extremely outrageous. When he is composing, it only looks as if he is in the room with you. In reality, he is far, far away in some exalted place where there is only him and the notes. But when he comes back, he brings with him music that is exciting, moving, and beautiful. That is why tonight and every night, people around the world are going to see Andrew Lloyd Webber shows and will continue to do so long after this curtain has come down, long after all of us here have made our final curtain calls. Because his music of the night is music for... for all time. He grew up in a house of symphonies, sonatas, and music lessons. His father was director of the London College of Music. At school, they taught him Mozart and Bach, but he wanted to write another kind of music, like Rodgers and Hammerstein and Elvis. Maybe he could combine them. He teamed up with songwriter Tim Rice. When a boys' school asked them to write a cantata, they chose a Bible story. It grew from a school concert to a full-blown musical, Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. We were out to shake up the musical, he said. The next idea was so outrageous. No producer would touch it. They made a record instead. Kids couldn't buy it fast enough. When it finally hit the stage, it rocked the house. For Andrew, it always begins with music and the search for the melody that lifts the story onto the stage and into history.
Don't cry for me, Argentina. The truth is I never left you. All through my wild days.
A hit in London, the show charged into New York, rest of America.
Don't you disdain.
Next, the poems of T.S. Eliot. Became the longest running show in Broadway history. I love theatre, he said, when it totally envelops you. He had raised Broadway entertainment to operatic heights. He dreamed of writing like his heroes. Now it's his music that belongs to the world.
Help me make the music of the No.
Kennedy Center Honors will return with Josh Groban, Betty Buckley, and Reba McEntire. Ladies and gentlemen, in tribute to Andrew Lloyd Webber, Corey Glover. Ladies and gentlemen, from London, the star of Evita, Elena Roger.
What's new? Buenos Aires. I knew I want to seem just a little tough on you. You'll be on me too. I get out here, Buenos Aires. Stand back. You ought to know what you're gonna get in me. Just a little touch of stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, Josh Groban.
Only then can
The Kennedy Center Honors will return with Josh Groban, Betty Buckley, and Reba McEntire. Ladies and gentlemen, in tribute to Andrew Lloyd Webber, Corey Glover. Ladies and gentlemen, the star of Grey Gardens, Christine Ebersole.
I don't know why I'm frightened. I know my way around here. The cardboard trees, the painted seas, the sound here.
Kennedy Center Honors, honoring Andrew Lloyd Webber, Zubin Mehta, Dolly Parton, Smokey Robinson, Steven Spielberg, Sarah Brightman.
I have been privileged to know Andrew now for 26 years. And have seen many sides to this complex and unique man. I have seen the searching and brilliant mind that has found hit shows in the pages of the Old Testament or the poems of T.S. Eliot. He is, by turns, and Andrew, don't kill me for saying this, funny, boyish, self-effacing, adorable, complicated, passionate, exasperating, lovable, explosive, demanding, innovative, and often extremely outrageous. When he is composing, it only looks as if he is in the room with you. In reality, he is far, far away in some exalted place where there is only him and the notes. But when he comes back, he brings with him music that is exciting, moving, and beautiful. That is why tonight, and every night, people around the world are going to see Andrew Lloyd Webber shows, and will continue to do so long after this curtain has come down, long after all of us here have made our final curtain calls, because his music of the night is music for all time. He grew up in a house of symphonies, sonatas, and music lessons. His father was director of the London College of Music. At school, they taught him Mozart and Bach, but he wanted to write another kind of music, like Rodgers and Hammerstein and Elvis. Maybe he could combine them. He teamed up with songwriter Tim Rice. When a boys' school asked them to write a cantata, they chose a Bible story.
Go, 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 go
grew from a school concert to a full-blown musical, Joseph and His Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. We were out to shake up the musical, he said. The next idea was so outrageous, no producer would touch it. They made a record instead. Kids couldn't buy it fast enough. When it finally hit the stage, it rocked the house. For Andrew, it always begins with music and the search for the melody that lifts the story onto the stage and into history.
Don't cry for me.
A hit in London, the show charged into New York. West of America. Next, the poems of T.S. Eliot. Became the longest-running show in Broadway history. I love theatre, he said, when it totally envelops you. He had raised Broadway entertainment to operatic heights. He dreamed of writing like his heroes. Now it's his music that belongs to the world.
Help me make the music of the night.
This ever-spinning playground, yes, everything's as if we never said goodbye. I don't want to be alone, that's all in the past. This world's waited long enough.
Ladies and gentlemen, from London, the star of Evita, Elena Roger.
What's new? Buenos Aires! I knew I wanna sing just a little stuff on you. You'll be on me too. I
muchos favores.